Students, this is the method of undetermined coefficients, and this method is used to find the particular solution or the particular integral of a non-homogeneous linear differential equation. We already know that non-homogeneous linear differential equations can be solved by already discussed methods, as in case 1 to 5. This method is an alternative to solve certain non-homogeneous linear differential equations. In this method, the key points is that to look at the non-homogeneous part, that is fx you have on the right hand side of the non-homogeneous linear differential equation, and the choice form of the particular integral y. In fact, in this method we choose the particular integral in advance by looking at the right hand side of the fx in the non-homogeneous linear differential equation. The form of yp is chosen with the help of some undetermined coefficients. So that is why the method is named as method of undetermined coefficients. Once these coefficients are determined and then are put into already chosen yp, you get the particular solution, and the complementary function is obtained in the usual manner. So for this we have summarized all the forms of particular integral in this table. For example, if fx has the form in left hand side of this table, we are choosing the form of the non-homogeneous linear fx, and in right hand side we are choosing the trial solution, or you can say the particular solution of the non-homogeneous linear differential equation. You know, if here the right and right hand side, the non-homogeneous term is like this, it can be any constant. If it is like this, then you can see the constant is 1. So in this right hand side also, we are given the form of the particular solution. The particular solution can be chosen in this way. This A is the undetermined coefficient here, and if A is a root of auxiliary equation, then the form is this. You write here x, and if A is repeated r times, then it is x raised to power r here multiplied. So A is the undetermined constant in all the cases, and it can be determined by various methods. Secondly, you can see we have already discussed that there can be polynomial form. So in general, in numerical problem, you will not have that kind of the polynomial, but it will have either just 1 plus x, or 1 plus x square, or 2 plus x square plus x cube. So it is the general form of the polynomial. It can be a simple one term like x square only, or x power anything. It can be like that. And in all the cases, the particular integral will be taken like that. Means you will consider the constant up to the term, the highest power of x in the fx. Suppose you are having 1 plus x cube, then you will consider 1 a0, you will consider a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube, because in left hand side you are having it up to x cube. And you know, k1, etc., these are the undetermined coefficients. So here are also some particular cases. If the left hand side of the equation like this here, the no term of y, then yp is chosen in this manner, that actually multiplied with this. And if terms of y and dy by dx are not there, then it will be like this. Similarly, the third case, you know, the terms k1 sin x, k1 constant, k2 cos ax, or combination of both k1 sin x. In all the cases, the particular integral will be chosen in this way, whether it is simply sin ax, or simply cos ax, or combination of these two. In all the cases, yp will be chosen like this, where a and b are the undetermined coefficients. So we can also have certain combination of our forms. For example, you see here k1 and k2, one particular case is there. If this ai are root of auxiliary equation and it is repeated r times, then particular integral like that. Now this is the combination of polynomial and this e raised to power ax, then you know e raised to power ax, it is this thing and some constant, and polynomial it is like that. So polynomial you are considering here into e raised to power x. This is the form of the particular integral in case of the combined form. Similarly, if here this a is repeated, this a is repeated r times around the repetition is like this. If you have a combination of exponential, trigonometric term, and the polynomial, then this is the combination like this. A naught, a one, a two, a k, x k, a to power means this is corresponding to this part. For this part, you are taking this, and constant may be considered this one, and into cos dx. And definitely, for cos dx, you require both the things, cos and sine. For example, this part as well as this part. The same thing is here, but these coefficients will be varied. So here also, a naught, a one, a k, b naught, b one, b k, are different coefficients will be different. So the whole procedure is given in the second part of the previous time. So you need to consider this PDF file and you should look at the solved examples as well as the unsolved problem.